Hello everyone, welcome back to Chinta. This is second part of the video on the topic of invariance principle. In the first part we have discussed the basic principle of invariance and the core idea of the topic. We had also discussed some problem to illustrate the idea of the principle, the birthday problem and the chess grid riddle. In this second part we will solve one more problem which is very interesting and fun to discuss. But before we start, I recommend you to go and watch the first part if you still haven't watched it, otherwise this part might be confusing to you. The link of the first part is in the video description or in the I button here. Now let's jump into the problem itself. And the question is, there is a room, and initially there is no one in the room. Every minute either one person enters or two person leaves the room. Is it possible to have exactly 50 persons in the room after 1 hour? The question is very simple to understand, but a little tricky to answer. There is a room and a lot of persons. Anyone can enter and exit the room using the entry and exit doors. But there is a condition. The entry or exit happens after every minute. And the entry is allowed for only one person, and the exit is possible only in pairs. So there are numerous possibilities of the number of persons at any specific time. For example, one of the possibility of the number of persons in the room after 10 minutes is 4. So in the total of 10 minutes, the total transformation will give us a result of 4 persons in the room. And one of the possibilities after 26 minutes might be 26, as if every minute one person enters the room. While this transformation is happening, the rule of entry and exit is followed carefully. So now the question is, if we keep going like this without breaking any rule specified, then is it possible to have exactly 50 persons in the room or not after exactly 60 minutes? I would like you to pause the video and try to find the pattern or the invariance here. That means something which is not changing over the entire task. So just pause the video and think about it. Let's discuss the solution. We will focus on the two main variables, the time in minutes and the number of person in the room after every minute, and then we will look for the invariance from the observation. And we will do this observation for first 10 minutes of the task. And we will try to look at each and every possible states of the situation for the first 10 minutes. So let's have a look here. After 1 minute, there is only one option, only one person can enter the room. And after 2 minutes, still only one option is available. One person can enter, but after 3 minutes, there are two options available for us. Either one person can enter, which will give us a total of 3 persons in the room, or two person can leave, which leaves us with no one in the room. After 4 minutes, we have two branches. The first branch will give us only one option, which allows us to enter only one person, and the second branch gives us two options. Either one person can enter, or two person can leave the room. So after 4 minutes, the possible states of the room can be 1 or 4 persons. Now after 5 minutes, again we have two branches. In the first one, only one option is available, that means one person can enter in the room. And in the second branch, there are two options available for us. Either one person can enter the room or two persons can leave the room. So after 5 minutes, the possible states of the room can be 2 or 5 persons. Similarly, if we keep going like this, then we will have the following possibilities at the respective specified time. Here it might feel difficult to find the connection between time t and the number of persons n. But if we subtract the number of persons from the time t, then we will get the pattern or our invariance in this situation. And from the list we can see that v is always a multiple of 3. So in this particular problem, the invariance can be written as time minus number of person in the room is always divisible by 3. In short, t minus n is divisible by 3. Now let's look at the main question, which is it possible to have exactly 50 person in the room after 60 minutes? So if we do t minus n, that means time minus number of persons in the room, then we will get 60 minus 50, which is 10. And clearly, 10 is not divisible by 3. So no matter what strategy we follow, there is no way to have 50 people in the room at the end of 1 hour. So the clear answer is no. It's not possible to have the 50 persons at the end of 1 hour. I hope you have found the video useful. So consider subscribing to the channel for more videos like this. Also, press the like button to show your support. And I will meet you in the next video.